I'm the fucking show.
Hey, what is up, my crazy subscriber? This is JoeKingJohn64, and today, people, I'll be reviewing the new game mode for Call of Duty Black Ops 4, Blackout. If you guys have not seen any of the gameplay, I've been live streaming this game over the past few days, and I can tell you so many things about this game mode. But first things first, I would like to say is that I thought this game mode was gonna fail. I thought it was gonna be terrible. I thought it was gonna be miserable. I thought it was gonna be like the worst game mode of all time. But at the end of the day, after playing more than 50 matches on this game mode, I can tell you guys, this game has a lot of potential. It has a way to grow in you. Like, it's good. It's a good game overall. So I like the battle royale mode for this game. It really like brings the best out of you. If you're like a first person shooter type of guy, and you know, you don't want to struggle with like Fortnite players bunny hopping, you know, building like a whole damn building and putting Wi-Fi in it, you don't want to deal with any of that. You just want to feel hardcore, you know, with a first person shooter gun, you know, you don't have to worry about third person shooter. This is your game. This is the game that you jump into, and I like it. You know, it's first person shooter. So let me start off with the review by saying that this game has a lot of potential, and let me tell you guys why. One, the movement system ain't that bad. You can slide across the floor. It's not that bad. You know, you can use it in your advantage when it comes down to close quarter combat, but that's about it. It's not that big of a deal. Normal running speed is not that fast or that slow. It's perfect. Nobody's running around like cocaine, like they're high on cocaine or something. Like, no, it's perfectly run speed. The next thing I would like to talk about will be the vehicles, because that's the first thing that everybody wants to know about, especially since the trailer did show the chopper. If you guys didn't know, the vehicles are super weak in this game. They don't do anything for you. They don't really, I mean, they provide transportation and all, but it's not as OP as people think. People think like, oh, you can just use the chopper and kill everybody down on the ground. No, you can actually take down a chopper with just one mag, either the assault rifle, the SMG, or the LMGs. You can take down the chopper with one mag, even some other vehicles too. So it's not OP. The vehicles in this game are not that bad. They're not OP. You have nothing to stress about when it comes down to vehicles. If anything, it actually acts like a death trap for your enemies, because they get stuck in there. The vehicle's about to blow up. It blows up in the middle of nowhere. They're pretty much screwed. So do not worry about vehicles, guys. It's actually not that OP. The next thing I would like to talk about is that Call of Duty really used their resources pretty much well. As you can see in the background gameplay, I did kill some zombies here and there, even in the live stream too. I was running around the asylum map, and it was really nostalgic, because I did play this map back in World at War and everything, and it was just super amazing to see it again. And just killing zombies while killing enemies, this just becomes like a really annoying moment, because if you guys do not remember, one of my live streams, I did die because I picked up the ray gun and I killed myself. That thing bounces off the damn walls, man. I forgot. But like, yeah, you can pick up the ray gun in this game mode. I'm like, what? You can pick up the ray gun and everything? And it's super strong too. It does like at least 45 points of damage. I was doing a good amount of damage with the ray gun. I don't know about you guys, but it was a hell of a fun time to use the ray gun and just running around the asylum and, you know, killing zombies and killing enemies. Like you see right now in the background, I mean, it's just super confusing because you don't know which is an enemy, which is a zombie. So it's a fun thing they added into this mode. They should have done it with Fortnite, but you know, Fortnite, they just concentrate on the Royale mode and skins. They don't really care about their own primary resource where all the game came from. You know, Fortnite is originally a zombie game. They didn't add a single zombie in the damn mode. So it would be amazing in order for Fortnite to increase their stuff is like make it more interesting, like add zombies to it. So anyways, moving on to the next thing I would like to talk about, the weaponry in this whole mode. It's actually pretty good. It's decent. None of them is OP over the other except for the Titan, though. I feel like the LMGs actually do a hell of a job here, especially since like it's an open area. I mean, if you're like running around an open area, of course you're gonna be shot down. So I kind of have a feeling of which gun is the strongest one already and which is the weakest. So don't pick up any SMGs, man. Those things are weak as hell. Pick up mostly assault rifles and LMGs and shotguns, and you'll be doing good out there. As far as I know, the weapon reselection in this mode is pretty good. There's a lot of weapons, so many weapons, ray guns, man. Even ray guns is in this game mode. So it's not a bad selection, really. It's not like you don't get bored. You don't always get the same weapon all the damn time. Every time you drop into a zone, you get different weapons all the time. So that's a good thing. It keeps it interesting. It keeps it really unpredictable. So that's a big plus for me right there. As far as I know, the lag or any kind of connection issues, they actually did run this game pretty well with 80 people first and then 89 after a while. I'm pretty sure they're gonna go 100 by the end of the week. But like, as far as I know, the connection is pretty much stable. There's no problems, there's no issues. So I'm like, wow, you guys actually did put the effort into the connection issues. So I'm impressed. Overall, I'm impressed of this mode. Vehicles, weapons, movement system, you know, everything's just too hardcore. You don't have to deal with bunny hoppers. You don't have to deal with shugging bullshit from Fortnite. This is your hardcore game. If you're a hardcore gamer in the first person shooter genre, this game is for you. If you're looking like for a battle royale mode that's hardcore, this mode is for you. I actually feel like this is actually more fun than HE1Z1, especially since the map is a little bit more smaller than the other royale modes. So you actually find yourself into more gun action fights and all that stuff. I had so many gun action fights, I'm like, man, this game is just so entertaining. I don't think I'm ever going to play the multiplayer mode for this game. I'm just going to play the Royale mode. This is going to actually be the first Royale mode that I'll actually spend like 24/7 or something. So expect a lot of this in the future. You'll see more Royale live streams in the future of Call of Duty Black Ops 4 Blackout. So that is it. That's my review, guys. My overall score, I want to give this mode an 8 out of 10. Very impressive, but hopefully in the future they do add more stuff with DLC and all that stuff. So I'm hoping for it to improve along the way. So that is it. Leave your opinion in the comment section, and I'll see you guys later.